100%, this is my worst experience with Moza. Wait, Wednesday last week, we came home with the Moza R12 and we finished the last disaster video, okay? Now, when we finished all that, I was like, oh, I haven't actually played on the Moza yet. I didn't really test it and I thought, oh, well, I better go and test it. So I jumped on the rig and after a few minutes, it felt bizarre again. When you steer at full force feedback, you can kind of feel this like notching feel. I was like, okay, this is a bit weird. And then eventually got to like some rough terrain and then it started to rattle like it did in the previous video. Then I got really annoyed. I got the tape out, put some tape on it, and then put the wheel back on and it stopped the noise. Then I was like, do I even live with it and just be like, well, bad enough at this point, I've returned back to the retailer, blah, blah, blah. I was like, no, do you know what? Let's ring them, see what they can do, and we'll go from there. So I looked online for the next one, which was the Moza R16. Now, if you look at the pictures online of the R16, it looks like it's got a gold shaft with a different end piece as such, okay? So I thought, oh, that's different, maybe we can get one of those. So I asked the retailer if we could maybe order one of those and then credit the account and I'll pay the difference. Unfortunately, they wasn't able to do that, so then we had to then like pay out a full amount for the second or third Moza product, which was £800. And then we ordered it and was like, right, we're gonna drive back again to Overclockers, return the R12 and then collect the R16. But unfortunately, when we got to Overclockers, they was like, yeah, you can't come back this time and see it being tested. I was like, okay, no problem. Obviously after the last video, I don't think it was too impressed. But anyway, we waited for them to come back and they went, look, one of our colleagues is actually testing the Moza R12 from what they've purchased and it's doing the same thing. So it's not only just me, it's somebody else as well that's had this issue. So I was like, right, well, get the R16, I'm gonna unbox it before I leave, and yeah, that's how this went.
Okay, so this is a little bit crazy. In my previous video, I said that my Moza R12 was okay because when we was here at Overclockers, we tested it and it seemed fine, but I couldn't really tell. I thought it was fine. I just thought it was a bad luck thing. But we got home, tested it yesterday. Today's Wednesday and it's doing the same thing. So I've gone and purchased a R16. And unfortunately, the R16 is doing the same thing.
They came back out and said, look, it's doing the same thing as the others. Now, this is three product lines, okay? The R9, R12, and R16 at this point have the same weird rattling issue with multiple different wheels, apparently. So I was like, look, I can either do two things. We can either go and leave it and just get a refund, or I'll just get another R16. Don't give me the one that you just tested because you just confirmed that it was faulty, and I'll go home and, you know, just do a fresh unboxing and see where we are from there. So today we will be showing you an unboxing of the R16 from the day I got it. Today is not the day that we got it, it was a couple days ago. So we were going to show you that, me unboxing it and then installing it. And then today I did record me testing it, but I'm going to do it again today because it wasn't the greatest of the videos. So we're going to go on today and show you the R16 in action and if it has any faults. Listen, it's brand new, untouched, and what is going on right now, we have no idea, right? I don't know, and I'm gonna explain more about it after we've unboxed this issue. This batch number, okay, on this product, 2024-05, okay? That's when this, oh my God, that's heavy. This is a beast of a thing. And I have genuinely only done this, my apologies, I have only done this so you guys understand that there is a huge issue over at Moza. Like, there is a problem, okay? But forget about that right now. Let's check this out. My first time spending this amount of money on a Moza product. To find out. So inside the box you have the usual stuff. Inside the box is the wheel, what do you know? Oh, I hope it's different, we've not checked it out yet. And you get the power supply, which is a monstrosity of a power supply, and it's a slight different design over the existing one, and a little bit more power. Okay, so a little bit more power than the pre-existing one that we just returned, the R12, and you get a cable. You should get Allen keys and such as well. So Allen keys, bolts, which is nice because we need those. And then everything else, just the usual instruction manual, don't need that. Get rid of the box. Big old box. So here is what the base looks like. It's nice, okay? It does look very nice. But, okay, what the issues are is this shaft here. This is the new redesigned shaft rather than the existing one, which looks like this. R16 V2, so it has all the peripherals at the rear. It is still only a 4-bolt design, so if you have a normal rig like myself, the Next Level Elite GT, you can still mount the R16 to it. You don't need no fancy bracket or anything. It should just bolt straight to the frame. In regards to all the peripherals at the back, you have pedals, e-stop, USB, power input, and your dash, your shift, and your handbrake. So all your handbrake and stuff should work if you have already pre-existing Moza stuff, okay? So we now have this. We're gonna install it onto our frame. Quickly install it, I should add, because I wanna crack on. It's now late for me. I've been driving back and forth to overclockers to get this replaced, but let's get it installed and see what it's actually like.
That's where the bolt holes are. So it's kind of like overhanging quite a lot. Does it really matter though? Drop down in the comments below, right? If a company sold you, Moza that is, not overclockers, okay? Overclockers have been fancy, right? If they sold you 5 products that was faulty, would you accept and go, oh, okay, you sold me 5 faulty products, I'm gonna buy a 6. Would you do that? This is probably good for you, bad for them, okay? At this point, really bad for them, but really good for you as a customer, because you will probably not know you've got an issue. They just haven't told you. And you're going around with your R9s and R12s thinking it's not, nothing's not. Just saying, W Moza though, because this product's gorgeous. This is exactly the same as the R9. I don't feel any movement yet. So there could be positivity here.
So we're now on a settle course, so we're going to do some drifting. Just to test it a little bit different to what I usually do. I want to kind of go through what my experience feels like on the R16 and how actually good is it, and is it worth the price point of considering, you know, you can get an R5 bundle for $550 with the round wheel. So first of all, we've had a shocking experience. Our experience is probably not what the same as what you're gonna get. I very much doubt you're gonna have a problem with Moza. Yes, we've had a massive issue with our product, and I can confirm the second R16 after buying 1 R9, 2 R12s, and 1 R16, because the last R16, they said it was faulty. I didn't want to take the chance and come home and it'd be faulty. Now this one, I have been testing it for the last couple of days, and I can confirm there is not a single noise from the shaft. It's completely silent. Everything works as it should. So I'm pretty impressed, actually, to be honest. I didn't think it was going to be this good. Now, I've come from the Moza R5 to the R9 to the 12, and can I tell the difference between all of them? I can certainly tell a difference in quality in just the way it feels, okay? Like, even from the 9 to the 12, there's a significant upgrade there. There's a significant difference, not in the design and the way it looks, just in the way the force feedback feels. Now, the R16 compared to the other two is that, like, literally day and night. Like, I can't explain the clarity of the force feedback and the way it feels, the way it delivers the force feedback. I don't know what's so different between the other products lines and the premium. It just feels like you are on a premium product. Like, that is hands down exactly how I feel now. We've got to say, my experience in the Moza, like, sort of way I've been sort of treated and the products that I've had to go through to make it, like, you know, work has been a bit of a joke, but I doubt it that you'll have the same experience. So I could probably still say you should still buy a Moza. They're still great quality products. I think, again, I've just been extremely unlucky in my case scenario. Like, and it had to be me, I guess. Like, at least, you know, if there is a problem with your Moza, you can just return it, get a new one. 90% of the retailers in the UK will just be like, send it back, we'll test it, and if it's something wrong, we'll just send you a new one. And Moza will just send you parts if you are mechanically minded and want to just do it yourself. That is a thing. I'm not really keen on that option, but they are like willing to, you know, work with you. Although in my case, you know, I didn't want Moza to send me stuff. I wanted just apology and, you know, some sort of goodwill gesture. It was never going to happen. It never happened. I never got anything or anything discounted. I never received no goodwill gesture, nothing like that. Which in a business point of view, they're not legally obligated to make it right. You know what I mean? They just sell a product. If it's good, it's good. If it's not, it's not. And that is kind of exactly how it is. I'm not salty about it because I'm still extremely impressed with this R16. Now, if I wasn't impressed with the R16, this video outcome would have been different. But I can certainly say the R16 is a brilliant product. Same as the others, to be honest. The R5 was great. And the only reason we are on a 16 is because of the process that we went through of the faulty stuff. Now, in one aspect, I'm pissed off with that. And then the other aspect, I'm grateful because I've had to experience the others before this, and I went through them all, which in 1 week is kind of crazy, but I'm very grateful that I've had the experience, even though it was a bad experience, just to see like what the worst case scenario is. And that's probably the last video, if you haven't seen it yet, which is pinned up here. If you haven't seen that video, then, you know, that's probably the worst case scenario. That's like 1000% like the worst thing that could happen. Now, that won't happen to you, I can guarantee it. Like, I just don't know how we managed to do that. I don't know how it managed to be such a thing. It was crazy. A lot of you guys may have assumed it was my faulty wheelbase, my faulty wheel. Now, as you can see or hear, there's no weird noises, not a single noise is coming from this Moza. So your Moza should be like silent. There might be a few vibration noises coming from your buttons and your sticks and stuff, but no noise from the bass itself or the quick release. I also, guys, yeah, I want to say, like, the overclockers customer care was fantastic. There was really apologetic, sympathetic, and they helped out in every case scenario, whatever they could, to follow along with their like sort of online procedures and like their company rules. You know, they followed and exceeded those rules. When we returned the R12, I said, look, I've had to pay another X amount of money for this R16, and I need the refund back ASAP for the other one that I bought. And they was like, yeah, we'll process it as soon as we can. We'll, you know, push it forward to the accounts team. And within the next day, I got the other money back. So in that case, that was fantastic. Your use case scenario, okay, usual case scenario, if you was to return a product to overclockers, the turnaround is 3 to 5 working days, only because they've got to make sure everything's in the box, go to the returns department, check it, you know what I mean, and then issue the refund and then to the accounts. And the accounts team is separate to the returns team, so they have to like liaise with each other, and sometimes they may not be at the desk, ECT, so there's that to consider when you are returning stuff. But the retailer overclockers, man, have been fantastic. Moza themselves, I'm not gonna have a great relationship with because they haven't said sorry. Well, they have said sorry now I've made the video. After I posted the video, they apologized. And they said that we could send you some quick releases, which I declined, because I know for a fact my quick releases on the wheel are completely fine. There's no noise from them, and if there were, I'd get them replaced. It was just kind of a bit of a shit situation when I went through four bases before I got a one that worked. It just kind of sucks. But it is what it is, and hopefully you guys can take something from this and be like, well, it's not the end of the world. If I was to be any other product, I don't think I would have got the fifth product. I'd have just gone, I'll go somewhere else. But I genuinely believe Moza have a fantastic product, and I believed in their product. As much as they let me down, I still believed in them. I was still, you know, even though I was annoyed, I still believed in the product. I want to try and to learn how to drift, and the Moza wheel is perfect for that. My final say on it is, I'd still recommend it. I'd still say it's better than Fanatec. The customer service needs work, but we're not all perfect, right? And it's not obviously Moza, like, who designed the stuff that was the problem. It was just a department in their infrastructure that let us down, not necessarily Moza themselves. So we got to look at it as an individual process, okay? So the returns part and the complaints department let us down quite a bit. But Moza in general, the experience you get from the product, still great. Like, as much as we had a problem, still rate it, man. I'm not gonna go anywhere else. You just have to be aware of, like, what can go wrong. And as long as you guys are aware of that and you know that when you're buying the product, then I think it's fine. As I'm not gonna lie to you guys and say, yeah, it's the best thing ever. The product is when it works, and the customer service sucks. I have seen instances though where other people have had great customer service. So I think it's like per user and how they see you. Maybe they don't like me for some reason. Kind of getting carried away with the video now. And I don't drift, by the way. I'm not much of a drifter. I don't really like drifting. I kind of went out of steam. But W anyway, I appreciate you guys watching. Don't forget to smash that like button, hit subscribe. Make sure you go and drop us a follow on Twitch and TikTok, where we post our daily content. Big up YouTube, big up the drifters. Let's go.